Hi guys, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are on the way to discover how to play the Grand Mafia on PC. As you can see now, you are able to display it on screen. We will be able to simply download and set up the Grand Mafia and enjoy this game on the Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. Then without further ado, let's go buddies. Before anything else my friends, to start we need to launch our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen. There is no need to type anything, simply because I added a link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived on this page on our own site of Usitility, in which we have a nice in-depth explanation on the best way to obtain the Grand Mafia on laptop or computer. We browse lower a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play the Grand Mafia on the PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of advantages of preferring using this emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the Grand Mafia by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on the button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila! Here is located the download. It is a file to execute. What we have to do now is to run the executable file. Okay, then we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduced the web browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installation software is pretty simple. It is made up of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will clarify what setup path really does. We basically just click it. Therefore we discover that they got here the path in which the emulator is going to be put in. If we desire to modify this folder we have to click on that browse option, and now we select another folder and set up the emulator exactly where we desire. I will set it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I pick install. Great. The install commences and it is going to carry on along with the download of these megabytes that happens to be represented on our computer screen. Once you save it on your hard drive, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your web access and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. At the moment they're working quite fast. The download is done, so straight away it continues on with the setup part. The installation will require a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your machine. The more powerful it is, the faster the software installation time and vice versa. If we merge the download and setup stage it may take a very long time, so be patient. It has now ended on my side. At this point, the emulator has actually been started successfully. As you will notice, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right when it gets to the end, the emulator is started for the first time. The reality is the emulator is already started, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as you understand, it created a couple of software icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the one we're concerned about. Anytime we are planning to start the Grand Mafia on the PC, we double-click that icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon isn't related to multiplayer or even anything at all like that. The fact is, it's an app icon that we would certainly never make use of. We should make the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to entry the Google Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is presented. At this point we are required to log on. Right now the moment we're on this page, we have to perform the next step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore mouse click on, sign in. At this point it announces, checking info. It might once in a while get blocked in, checking info, and so it does not move ahead. In that case, you should attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may almost certainly be repaired. At this point we shall provide our email address and password. The email has to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you make use of the same email you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. Therefore I am going to submit my data and I'll return as soon as I have accomplished it. That's all, information typed. Discover Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We will say yes to all of them by just clicking, I agree. After that, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected and it will produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To set up the app, we have to visit the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking the app icon marked in green. Currently that we are exploring the desktop of that emulator for Android, we notice that we come with here the install video game option. We simply click on this button. At this point we access to the Android game. Let's simply click right here on the install button that I am presenting now in green color. This will initiate the software setup. Straight away it would download on your desktop or laptop and install the video game. It typically takes a little while, or perhaps it may possibly be extremely fast. It all is subject to on the web connection. It has actually ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this specific option that I'm showing in green, to be able to run the Grand Mafia for the very first time. Shall we press on this My Games Choice proceeding? I am at present on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to mouse click on this new The Grand Mafia software icon which has been provided. That Android game is started for the first time on your computer. Now there we get it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of that emulator. It's right here, we have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is simply the very first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon that I am actually designating in green color. Then the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the case that we like to play the application using all the screen, we hit this app icon. And we might presently be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen mode. To leave the complete screen setting, just click the F11 key. So we would undoubtedly currently play in regular display mode. From now, I am ready to explain you the computer keys mapping that is really extremely exciting. That strategy we definitely will be ready to utilize the game far more effortlessly. The first thing is to click this software icon. And right now there you will have the ability to complete the recommended configuration settings. Let me leave the default settings, however if you plan to improve it, you can also do this with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the incorrect language, such as, in Japanese. So to set it up in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. So right here throughout many other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can also opt for the language we need, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. Once the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, along with the video game, next time we launch it, will also be in the chosen language. At this time, you will find another thing that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail telling you that a brand new electronic device has been connected with our Google account. It should check with us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Yup, we shouldn't be troubled, since the emulator is emulating in Google Android electronic device. And then to identify which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we browse here to the model selection. And now we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our video user demo. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that you thought it was handy. If that is so, bring it a great like, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment box down below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every now and then, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of those videos that happens to be showing up on the suggestion of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming videos. Bye.